How to send a fax from your PC. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Yes, faxes are still a thing. Surprises me too. Here's a question. I have Windows. Would I be able to send and receive faxes? And if so, how do I do it? Would I need new hardware? The short answer is no, you don't need new hardware. Fact is, these days you really don't need any hardware at all. All you really need is the ability to basically take a picture of or scan the document you're attempting to fax somewhere, which even that isn't always required because we're creating the documents on the very PCs that we're using. So, what's the way to send a fax today? Well, first off, a disclaimer. I'm going to recommend a specific service to you, and I want to be clear, I do not get anything out of this recommendation, other than knowing that my friend who owns it will get a little bit more business. But like I said, I'm not getting any remuneration for this recommendation. And that recommendation is faxzero.com. I'll go ahead and bring it up on the screen here so you can see what I'm talking about. So we'll scroll down to the sender information, receiver information, and then choose the files you want to fax to somebody else. You can have a cover letter. There's a little bit of bot prevention here. This is absolutely free. If you've got a document that you want to fax to somebody and it's something you do rarely, this is a great solution. Now, free means that there will be some advertising on the cover sheet that goes with the fax. If you don't want that, if you want no cover sheet at all, in other words, you want your first page to be the cover sheet, then you pay like $1.99 to send a fax. But honestly, for people that don't send faxes regularly or often at all, this is a wonderful solution. It's just a website that you go to. If you're sending a lot of faxes, then yes, you might want to look at some services or maybe even purchasing your own fax machine. But like I said, that is something that is so rare these days that it's just not something that I'm going to recommend at all. Now, the one question that comes up, of course, is, well, great, this is wonderful if my documents are already digital. If I've created my document on my PC, it's a docx or a PDF or something, clearly I can just choose the file, upload it, and send it to somebody. What if I've got paper? Well, that is something that actually has improved quite a bit in recent years. To begin with, if you've got a scanner, well, you're done. You can scan your document, create a PDF out of it, and send it. If you've got a smartphone, if you've got an iPhone or an Android with a camera, the cameras have become so good these days that they will operate just fine as a pseudo scanner. In fact, there are applications that will take care of the fact that you can almost always end up taking pictures of the documents at an angle. So the document like is a little narrower at the top than it is at the bottom or something like that. The tools specifically for this kind of scanning will automatically correct for that kind of stuff. I believe Adobe has an app specifically for scanning documents to a PDF on your phone. Then you can get the PDF to your computer and once again use FaxZero or whatever service you want to send that fax. Now, there's one last thing to talk about, and that is signatures. One of the reasons that some industries seem convinced that they have to continue to use faxes is because they want you to sign a document. What they envisioned you doing is receiving a document from them that requires a signature, printing it, signing it, scanning it, and then sending them the scanned result with your signature in place. There are a couple of scenarios. Sometimes that sequence that I just outlined, yeah, you gotta do it. Sometimes it's the easiest thing to do. However, depending on who you're dealing with, it may be enough to have an image of your signature that you then drag and drop onto the document. It may be enough to use the signature capability in your PDF viewer to place a signature in the signature spot. It may be enough for some, like websites, where you just type in your name and a date, and that becomes your signature. So signatures, while they are important, usually have several different options that aren't quite as cumbersome as having to print, sign, scan, and send. Now, one last word about receiving a fax. This is something that I'm not going to cover in any detail because it is so incredibly rare. Typically, even in the send, sign, scan, and send scenario, it's not something you received via fax. It's usually a document that they've attached to email. So it is incredibly rare that you'll actually have to receive a fax. If you do, there are services out there that will give you a phone number and let you sign up and receive faxes to that number, which they will then email to you. But like I said, 999 times out of 1,000, you don't need it. What matters more is the ability to send a fax, and for that, I recommend you use faxzero.com. For links, for comments, for updates to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2640. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.